Now, just explain a little bit what we're doing here tonight. This is a spring festival. We are celebrating spring. And all the people from the community who have the ability to bring about a rebirth every time spring rolls around are here tonight. However, before we get to the community people, I have the pleasure of introducing another member of Lillian's family, and that is her sister, Marion. Marion, you just want to come out here and say hi. I'm sure everyone will be interested in seeing another member of a very famous family of Greenpoint. On the other hand, so what did you think of your sister?
I'm very proud.
You should be
very proud. Exactly. I'm very happy to be here tonight, which I try to come in as much as I could.
Well, I'm sure she's very pleased to have you.
Yes, I enjoyed tonight all the people I met.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, there is another member, a very special member, and that's a very important person in Lillian's life, and that's her daughter, Lisa. Now, Lisa is a very special girl. Ever since she was 3, 4, 5 years old, she's been helping her mother bring about a community that we are all proud of. So, Lisa, would you like to come over here? God, I know you're proud of your mom. So how did you think about it?
Well, my mother, there are no one word to say to describe my mother, but she's a very beautiful person, and all her things. She's totally devoted to community, to people, to life, and living. And tonight is just the beginning of a lot more to come, and a lot more success to her. I wish her all the best.
Okay. Yeah, Lisa, you come from a long line of fighters,
yes.
And it's not going to end here tonight.
I know.
Okay, well, now we'll get to some of the community people. I myself, by the way, my name is Angel Capolino, and along with Mr. James Glenn, we are from Neighborhoods Today. Neighborhoods Today is a local cable TV service. It's a nonprofit organization, and what we hope to contribute is by putting Greenpoint in smaller communities on the map. Unfortunately, when you come from a small community, you don't get any media recognition unless you have a gigantic disaster or you do some unbelievable feat. However, we're working towards bringing this neighborhood across that other side of the river and making us well known. Okay, enough for our purposes. Now I'm going to introduce some very distinguished guests from all over, representing all the different organizations that make up our special community. And first, since I'm an artist, I'm going to start with the artist of the group. We're going to have a representative from the Greenpoint Repertory Company. Okay, Greenpoint Rep, are we ready?
I'm not with the Greenpoint Rep anymore.
Well, why don't you come here and tell us how you more or less started it? Because what we are concerned with right now is how things get started. Now, the Greenpoint Rep has quite a bit of a reputation. Just could you give us a little bit of how you just started such an organization?
Well, like I said, I'm not with the Greenpoint Rep anymore, but I was involved for a number of years. I came in after Lillian Giandolfo had already started organizing the Greenpoint Rep, but at that time, I have to admit that we were still pulling ourselves up by our bootstraps. We weren't very well known in the community, and we felt that several things needed to be improved. One thing that we tried to improve was the fact that there was no recognition of the group itself. And we somewhat remedied that by starting four programs for the plays to take advertising. Just the constant search for advertising got the name out there on at least Manhattan Avenue. And also, once we went in for advertising, what we would do is at that point say, well, if you can't take an ad, can you please put up a poster? And by that time, there was a lot better name recognition for the group. What followed after that, which has helped tremendously for the Greenpoint Rep, is the fact of the dinner theater that they now have with the Lions Club and the YMCA. That has allowed the Greenpoint Rep to become much better known through the association with the Y and the Lions Club.
Okay.
And tomorrow night marks their fourth joint effort.
Now it's Greg, right?
Craig.
Okay, now could you just introduce yourself and tell us what you are doing now?
Okay, I am, like I said, no longer a member of the GRC, I'm on the board of managers of the local YMCA here in Greenpoint. I'm also public relations manager for the YMCA. I also am publicity director and a member of the Greenpoint Lions Club. And as far as my theater affiliation is concerned, a friend of mine who we met through the Greenpoint rep began our own production company called Bleacher Bums Productions. The name coming from the first time that he and I worked together with the GRC when we did Bleacher Bums back in June of 82.
I heard that's very successful.
We're getting there. We do dinner theaters for organizations who are interested in fundraising. And the usual fundraising event is a Halloween party or a cake sale or a dinner dance. And what we hope to do is to say, after about 4 or 5 years of the same thing, maybe you could possibly try a dinner theater. And I was with about 2 or 3 other people responsible for the dinner theater that GRC is doing now, and I think that's just probably a natural extension of what I had done in the past.
Well, I want to thank you, and from neighborhood today, if you ever need anything, take it right here.
Okay, great.
Okay.
Thank you, Rachel.
All right, I think we have one other representative. We can't do without him. He's from the local YMCA, the Greenpoint branch, and he's responsible for keeping us all in fit. Now, Greenpoint, you're a YMCA?
Oh, sure, I was all ready for this.
Let's have our director. Okay.
How are you?
I'm doing fine. Now, could you just introduce yourself and give
sure.
us a little bit about what's going on at the Y?
Well, I'm Marshall Klein, and the executive director for all of 7 weeks at the Greenpoint Y, but I've been in the YMCA movement for 14 years, and I guess what the YMCA is doing in Greenpoint is what it's trying to do all over the world, which is provide some comprehensive services to help folks enjoy life a little better. I think it's one of the most important things we're all looking for is to try to get the most out of life. And the Y does it on a basic concept, which is real simple. It was invented by the YMCA founders in the 1860s, which is spirit, mind, body, the triangle that example of the staying power of the YMCA movement, because the Y was built here in 1906. It's an old building, it's got its problems physically, it's architecturally interesting in places and kind of depressing in other places, but the YMCA really goes beyond the four walls and into the community, and it's really hard to go anywhere in the world without finding somebody that hasn't dealt with or gone through a YMCA. I think that's one introduction to the organization. I think my bosses would be proud of me.
Thank you. Well, I guess that says it all. Basically, we're just a bunch of regular people just trying to do the best we can and hoping that our community only gets better and better and better.
Wow, I got to tell you, coming to Greenpoint is real special because this is Brooklyn, like I grew up in Brownsville. Today was a beautiful day of spring. It's real nice to be invited here and share this lovely day with you.
Oh, thank you. Okay, now before we close, we must have Lillian back. Lillian? Lillian? Lillian's a very busy person at this time. However, Lillian, just to sum it up, there's no one more important that I would like to hug and say thank you than to you. And may we have a good and successful year.
Oh, I'm sure we will have. With people that are all here and dedicated, I'm sure we will. I would like to read one thing that I am yearning for, and I think all of us. This was a letter written on behalf of the repertory, and I wrote it to Joseph Papp, and I state here, we can see you with your tall buildings and your beautiful skyline. I hope our borough president, Howard Golden, whom we all... Let's applaud for Howard Golden. And we all applaud for him. Okay. I would like him to hear this one day. Okay, I will repeat. We can see you with your tall buildings and your beautiful skyline, but you cannot see us. I have a dream that one day our piers will be revitalized and hold many enterprises. Our ports are yearning for foresight of what can be. We must have vision to push forward if we are to succeed in keeping Greenpoint stable. I have been trying to bring this message over the past years at the chamber and many civic organizations and wherever I could be heard. Now this was after, we did forget to say that the repertory did get a SNAP award, which is quite prestigious. And it was awarded by Mrs. Mondale and Estelle Parsons at Central Park. And I was privileged to accept the award. And then many letters followed from Howard Golden. And why am I saying him? He just has produced so much in my mind because I met with him at the Long Island Historical Society when they proclaimed it Brooklyn Museum. And he just seems to be the interesting man of the hour to produce for Brooklyn everything we want. Okay.
Well, I think the best way to end it up is to just go back right to the beginning. So here again is Lillian's family, her past.
If we could hold on to the heritage of our forefathers, original plight combined with the technology of today's modern world, what a romance of a century this would be. I introduce to you tonight six generations of my family's history, all of whom crossed that famous Brooklyn Bridge. Through pictures and artifacts of their day, this all started at 114 Sickle Street in Williamsburg, where my great-great-grandma and grandpa raised 16 siblings. There were stables in the back where merchants kept their horse and wagons to sell their vegetables and fruits at the famous Wallabout Market. The building, of course, no longer stands, but the spirit of their being will forever be part of the area. The firehouse, which was built next door, was a place some of the children's Mr. Fall would slide down the fire pole. Eventually, Fred Seitz, son of my great-great-grandparents, was a fireman there. Pictures displayed tonight, one of Fred in his fireman's uniform, the other the fire truck of their day, drawn by horse and wagon. Grandma was of German descent. She was the oldest of the siblings. I have fond memories of her taking me to the Jewish theaters. Although I could not speak the language, Grandma did. She met and married Frank Pertelli. I venture to say being with Grandma was an adventure for me. As I stated, she married Frank Pertelli and she met at the famous Mount Carmel's feast that we all know about, of course. And thus an Italian, as they say, came into the family. Her sisters and brothers married into different ethnic groups, making a League of Nations all their own, sharing their love and humor with all. For as you see, the dinner table in our family was a place where we all got together and related little stories, and it was the table was just the place to be and enjoy. And visiting my relatives, I found that they related back to this. For dinner or breakfast, as a young girl, it was quite a feat for me. Bagels and lox for breakfast, another relative spaghetti and meatballs, Swedish food. So many ethnic dishes served with the dignity of their family roots. My own mother married Salvatore Striano, who served in the First World War at the age of 16. He served in France. Their romance began on Middleton Street in Williamsburg. She asked him for the time, and they remained together for almost 50 years until his death. He died as he had lived in dignity. The enemy was cancer. His last words and famous quote was, "Always be on the alert to observe." Mother went to the Conservatory of Music, Gates Avenue. It was only 50 cents at that time. She played the violin. She has taught us in her gentle manner to put music in our hearts and the sound to our ears. Through good times and bad, there would always be music in our home. So be it. In speaking of my family, I speak of all the families, of our communities, their roots, their life, their loves. Tonight, as you look around, the flowers you see have a meaning. Yes, it is spring, and we are here in Greenpoint, USA, the garden spot of the world, stated the Honorable Pete McGinnis. Let us nurture the needs of our youth. They are our flowers. The needs of our people, the challenge all of us have to make our area a better place. In today's world, it's not easy. Let us journey into the past tonight with foresight for our future. My honored guests all, I thank you for sharing with me your presence.
Well, thank you for having me, Bill. You know, Lil, I've only known you a short time. But in this short period of time, I've become very fond of the ideals that you seem to enhance here in Greenpoint proper. And you know, as a missionary, we're dedicated to the principles of the Gospel of Jesus. And you personify these ideals and these precepts which Jesus has given us. And because of the fine work that you have done here, I would like to present you with this honorary commission to our ranks of missionaries. And here, as you can see, is your name. And before I finish, I'd just like to state one thing, that here you see we're dedicated to the precepts of our Lord Jesus in Matthew chapter 25, verses 31 to 46, which in essence is the last judgment of in front of God and our Savior Jesus Christ. And to those things that you've been dedicated to all these years, this is a great honor to bestow this upon you.
Thank you, Reverend, very much.
Thank you for having me.
Oh, thank you very much, really. It's quite unexpected, and the feeling within me is really filled with spirit, even more than I have. And I thank you, really.
Thank you.
I'm very honored.
William Babstock. I'm the autonomous missionary here in Greenpoint. I've been here for some 2 years now. And an awful lot of people ask me, Reverend, what do you do here? What does your work entail? And I endeavor to help those that are suffering mainly from the insidious disease of alcoholism. And, you know, people ask me, what is the definition of an alcoholic? Well, I can only say what the American Medical Association has told me about this. It's simply stated, it is a mental obsession coupled with a physical compulsion. You see, alcohol, aside from its addictive qualities, also has a psychological effect that modifies thinking and reasoning. One drink can change the thinking of an alcoholic so that he feels he can tolerate another and another and another ad infinitum. Or as they say, one drink is too many and thousands not enough. The alcoholic can learn to completely control his disease, but the affliction cannot be cured so that he could ever return to alcohol without adverse consequences. Treatment primarily involves not taking a drink. Now, to get on to the work that I do here in Greenpoint, Brooklyn. I visit a great many people who are suffering from this insidious disease. People who live in furnished rooms, welfare hotels. Some of my clients are rather wealthy people too, I might add. You see, this disease of alcoholism knows no bounds. You may be a poor man, you may be a rich man, but this disease could afflict you as well. through what I call sobriety through the Holy Spirit. Now, from this point on, from sobriety, we then motivate the individual who has, this has to be a mutual motivation, by the way, through a detoxification. Then comes the sobriety through the Holy Spirit. And as Jesus Christ said, you cannot keep the Holy Spirit unless you give it away to others in need of it. Now, from this point on, as I said, we go the modalities of the recovery process. This recovery process may take as long as 3 years in some cases, and some it may take 5, but those are very rare. However, we do come to fruition in most of our return to work and be recovered. And this is the main thrust of my ministry here at Greenpoint. Thank you for listening.
You did not hear my beginning. It's all about Williamsburg. That's where my great great grandparents come on Siegel Street. Assembly in that area lived on that same block, of course, many years later. But you will hear, when you see the tape, you hear all about Williamsburg. That's where my
I'm from Williamsburg. I live there.
Yeah, well, I live there all my life.
And except my family, and I purchased the project there, our house. So we're, I'm so very well aware of the beauty of the homes in this area and exactly what it takes to put them
together. But Williamsburg is beautiful too, and with foresight it could even be better.
Oh,
it's
yes.
Going to be.
Some renovation is needed.
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm stating.
I myself have tried to renovate a home.
Well, this is so nice to talk about. Really?
Two of them marble. Oh, to scrape the paint.
That's a place where Siegel Street, the Wallabout Markets, my great-great-grandfather was part of all that, you know? So I know it is a beautiful place.
We're
a lot of nice things happen. It's coming to again, but we sort of separated. You know, in our society we have. But now it's time for us all to get together again.
Definitely, that's
get on God's soul train and let's just get there. Let's see together.
I can interest people outside this community.
Well, let
to come
me
back
speak
in.
With you then, okay?
Okay, to come back into the community.
Yeah.
And let
I wish you could have heard
here.
What was said, but you will when it's.
But I must
okay.
tell you, I do love the art as I see it, and the furniture mostly, because I am,
you seem where,
especially the poster bed, I'm in love with it, because I love the
George Washington
and the colonial.
No, I've held on to the old, you know, always, I've been a modern mother.
Well, this modernization is, there's nothing wrong with modernization, but they're,
you read my speech, you'll see, but I'll write them just what I love, you know, and we'll meet, okay? Yeah, thank you very much.
And if we can only...
Because neighbors have to shake hands, right? And that's what tonight is all about.
And interest others as a
yes.
community oh, about the beauty and the buildings.
Ralph has been
is
part of that humanitarian...
Well, you know what I would suggest? That you come up with a Williamsburg postcard like she come up with the Greenpoint.
That's true. We have one for Greenpoint. We should come up with one for Williamsburg.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm doing something on that.
Have you got that book that the Williamsburg Savings Bank come up with?
No, I haven't.
I have their original first... paper artifacts, the Williamsburg Bank, and whatever. You see, but this is money, and I invested completely so much. And I'm happy, because this card has come back to me from all over the world. I have now 62. Saturday, one come back from Florence, Italy. A message that we're here. You know, I give it to someone who's going wherever, and they send it back. And we could, our next project could be a card of Williamsburg.
I'll tell you what our next project should be. To have a contest with all the school children so that Williamsburg can have a Williamsburg flag by Greenpoint.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
That is true.
Wonderful.
I got PS50 in that community.
Do you want to know something? Lindsay was mayor at that time. He was so excited about the idea that he encouraged us actually to go forward with it. And the day of the ceremonies dedicating the flag. He came to McCarran Park in a helicopter, and he landed, you know, on Bedford Avenue there, come out, and was it, there were about, were you there that day, Lillian?
Please, I was admiring the pictures in the back room.
Excuse me, there were about 1,000 people in the park that day.
McCarran Park.
Unfortunately, we had all the TV channels there, but unfortunately, that was the day the Israeli war broke.
Purchased this old house on down. The house was gorgeous. It was sealed with cinder block and tin, and the home was beautiful because it had five working fireplaces, some of it marble, all right, tall 12-foot ceilings. The Italian artwork done in the ceilings. We brought that all back.
Beautiful. Okay?
And we still haven't finished the house. And this house we purchased.
This should be a hot barn that we know.
Right? Now there are many buildings in this neighborhood.